So today we will discuss about the two half spin system. That means two atoms are concentrated nuclei means the natural abundance is more, and half spin system means the I value, that is nuclear spin quantum number, will be half. Both the atoms in all the cases, phosphorus, fluorine and hydrogen, all have half spin and they are concentrated nuclei also. That means their natural abundance is very high. Now come to the first example, that is hydrogen fluoride. So what will be the splitting pattern? How this molecule will be splitted in NMR spectrum? So if you see the neighboring partner, that is fluorine, and for this fluorine hydrogen, so both have spin value half, so we will expect a doublet for hydrogen, and for fluorine also we have a doublet, so we will get two doublets in NMR spectrum. So if you are confusing how to difference between two doublets and a quartet, you can see my previous video also, you can clarify from that video. So now if you see this PF3, that is this molecule PF3, so there are a central phosphorus atom and three fluorine are attached to this phosphorus, and the angle between this angle, that is phosphorus fluorine, this is the angle, and that is 120 degree, you can see. So if you see the phosphorus, this will three neighboring fluorine atoms which have half nuclear spin, so the splitting pattern will be quartet. For this phosphorus we will get a quartet, and this three fluorine will give a doublet due to one phosphorus. Similarly, you can see in PH3 molecule also we will get three hydrogen doublet and one phosphorus quartet, and the intensity ratio is 1:3:1 because this is nuclear spin value is half. If we get half nuclear spin, then Pascal triangle rule will be applied, and if that is one, then non-Pascalian rule, you can see my previous video, the splitting pattern will be different. Now come to this very good example, that is PF5, phosphorus pentafluoride. Now this is you can say fluxional type molecule. What does that mean? That fluxionality means these bonds are fluxional, means they are interchange at room temperature. These equatorial bonds can come to this axial, and axial bond come to equatorial. So this is called fluxional type of molecule, you can say, or you can also called there will be some Barry pseudo rotation. So now if you see at room temperature, this all fluorines are equivalent, because due to fluxionality all fluorines are equivalent. So we will get, for phosphorus we will get a sextet, because of all are equivalent, all fluorines are equivalent, we will get a sextet for phosphorus, and for 5 fluorine we will get a doublet. Now if you decrease the temperature, that is at -100 degree centigrade, if you decrease the temperature, now this fluxionality will be disappear and this molecule will be rigid. Due to that rigid property, now this will act as a equatorial fluorine and this is axial fluorine. Now this is different environment and this is different environment. So for phosphorus we will get, for these two fluorine, because of these two fluorine we will get triplet, and this three fluorine we will get a quartet. So triplet of quartet for phosphorus, triplet of quartet I have mentioned here also, you can see that. Now for this three fluorine we will get, due to phosphorus we will get doublet, and these two fluorine we will get a triplet. So for equatorial 3 phosphorus we will get a doublet of triplet. Okay, now for these two axial fluorine, for these two axial fluorine we will get doublet due to phosphorus and quartet due to 3 equatorial fluorine atoms. So for these two fluorine atom we will get doublet of quartet. So doublet of quartet you can see, and doublet of triplet, this is fluorine 19 NMR. Now come to the next question, that is isomer of BCl2F3. So there are three possible isomer. You can see, you can also try your own self. When two chlorines are in axial position, then equatorial, then one axial and one equatorial. Okay, so if you see, the chlorine molecules are NMR inactive, you can say. Now this fluorine, you can say this is NMR active and phosphorus is NMR active. So for 3 fluorine we will get doublet, and this phosphorus we will get a quartet. So 3 fluorine doublet and 1 phosphorus quartet. Now for this isomer, you can see that these 2 chlorine are NMR inactive, and these 2 fluorine, if you see, these 2 axial fluorine are in different environment, and this fluorine are in different environment, that is, this is axial position and this is equatorial position. So we will get 3 type of NMR spectrum. For this fluorine we will get a peak, these 2 fluorine we will get another peak, and this phosphorus we will get another peak. For phosphorus, you can see doublet due to this fluorine and triplet due to these 2 fluorine. So doublet of triplet for 1 phosphorus. Now for this 1 fluorine we will get a doublet for phosphorus, and for triplet for these 2 phosphorus, fluorine. So we will get a doublet of triplet for this fluorine, and for these 2 fluorine you can say we will get doublet of doublet, because of 1 phosphorus we will get doublet, and that will split it again due to this fluorine, that is doublet. So doublet of doublet for these 2 axial fluorine. Now come to this third molecule, that is another isomer of this BCl2F3. So if you see this, this phosphorus is at axial position and these 2 phosphorus are in equatorial position. So for this phosphorus we will get a doublet for this fluorine, and for a triplet these 2 fluorine. So doublet of triplet, what is that, 1 phosphorus doublet of triplet. And for this 2 fluorine, you can say these 2 fluorine due to neighboring this 1 phosphorus only we will get a doublet, and for this 1 fluorine we will get another doublet. So doublet of doublet for this equatorial 2 fluorine. And if you see that 1 fluorine we will get doublet of triplet, because of, you can see, you can apply the same rule. This for this fluorine we will get doublet for this 1 phosphorus, and for these 2 fluorines we will get a triplet, that will in couple with these 2 fluorines that will give a triplet. So doublet of triplet for this fluorine. For phosphorus we will get doublet of triplet, and for this 2 fluorine we will get doublet of doublet. Now come to the difference between doublet of triplet and triplet of doublet. And you are getting in NMR spectrum this both kind of problem, that a single signal will be splitted into a doublet, then it will split into triplet, or first it will give a triplet into doublet. How to recognize that it is a doublet of triplet or triplet of doublet? So if you get a doublet of triplet, doublet means 1:1 ratio, then triplet means 1:2:1, then another triplet means 1:2:1. So we will get 2 triplet if it is splitting like doublet of triplet. 2 triplet we will get in the ratio 1:2:1, 1:2:1. Now if it is triplet of doublet, triplet means 1:2:1, first it will split into 1:2:1, then triplet of doublet means each will be splitted into doublet. So this one signal will split into doublet 1:1, this will also 1:1, this will also 1:1. So we will get 3 doublets if it is triplet of doublet, 3 doublets. And if it is doublet of triplet, then we will get 2 triplets. So by that you can distinguish which is doublet of triplet and which is triplet of doublet. So this is for this video. I will give another example of this multinuclear NMR. We will continue. So thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe and comment also, like my video. Thank you.